everyone, Draco Magnius here for another episode of Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII, Journey of the Cursed King. In the last episode, we recovered supplies from all around Castle Trodane to, you know, get things. Because I like getting things for our quest. And in this episode, we came to the, in the last episode we came to the library. In this episode, we're going to see if we can find any information on the ship. Starting way back here. It's a book entitled Explosive. Handle with care. What, the book is explosive? Oh my god! I will carefully flip the next pages. Generally speaking, rock bomb shards can only be used once. But it's a little known fact that it's possible to modify them so they can be used over and over again. The method is simple. Combine a rock bomb shard with a wizard staff in an alchemy pot. One word of caution, however. Rock bomb shards modified this way will lose some explosive power. Think of it as a small price to pay for reusability. Gillian discovered a new recipe for the alchemy pot. A wizard staff and a rock bomb shard. I am curious to see what that would make, but I still need my staff. Do I have another staff in there, or did I sell that when I got it? I think I might have sold it when I got it. Yeah, I did. Oh well, no use crying over spilt milk. I can always go back to Simpleton and buy a new one when I have enough money. There's a lot of interesting alchemy recipes like that in this library, if I'm not mistaken. A book entitled Better Living Through Cheese. Here's a hot tip. Try mixing cheese with an item that heals your body, then eating the result. You'll find that it gives you even more of a boost than eating normal cheese. Gillian discovered a new recipe for the alchemy pot. Healthy cheese. Plain cheese and a healing item. That healing item should be obvious, but the caption will appear now. Okay. So, that's those two shelves. Let's check this one. The book is so thick that Gillian's arms get tired just holding it. Well, that wasn't helpful at all. And nothing interesting. Really? There's so many books in here, and you can find one that's not interesting? You know, Gillian, bravo! Bra-freaking-vo! Anyway, an excellent elven elixir. I have discovered that by the addition of a certain liquid, I can give Yggdrasil Dew a totally new effect. As I learnt the technique from an elf, I have dubbed the compound Elven Elixir. This potent little mixture can restore one's magic power. Gillian discovered a new recipe for the alchemy pot. Elven Elixir. Yggdrasil Dew in a liquid. I assume that's magic water, if I had to guess. Nothing of interest. Sorry if this gets a little tedious, but I kind of have to do this. There's no way around it. Nothing of interest. Okay, seriously, why would the game put books in this gigantic library that we're currently in compared to anything we've seen before and make books that are useless? Or bookshelves that are useless. Oh, excuse me. It appears to be the diary of a soldier. Dear diary, oh the shame, my iron shield is so old, I'm embarrassed to go in battle. It makes me look like some kind of marauding barbarian. But guess what? I heard you can combine something silver with an iron shield and you can make a beautiful white shield. Now all I have to do is pillage some silver for myself. Really? You're afraid of looking like a barbarian, so you're going to pillage some silver to make your shield look better. Anyway, we discovered a new recipe. White shield, an iron shield, and something silver. You know what's gonna happen. It's happened enough times already. Ooh, which shelf next? I just went from that one, right? Or was it this one? This one. Okay, so I'll go to this one now. Also, it's daytime, so I think the event that actually happens in here, because there is an event that happens in here, happens at night. So, I might cut this after I read all the books. It's a book called Must-Sees for Sightseers. If you aspire to call yourself a well-traveled individual, there are certain places in the world that you simply must visit. Topping the list are the goddess statue on the Holy Isle of Neos, Okay, keep that in mind. And the Lord High Priest's residence, which floats on an island in the sky. How does one get to the Lord High Priest's residence in the sky? You don't have to be a holy pilgrim to be impressed by these sacred and spectacular sights, that's for sure. Maybe we'll see those at some point. I don't know. I don't think I've ever seen them. It's a fashion magazine called Vogue Alchemy. Tired of wearing the same old outfit every time you head into battle? If your answer is yes, don't fret. Try alchemy. Just take a look at this example. Stone hard hats may be functional, but they're hardly fashionable. Just combine one with two bronze knives, though, and voila! Your heavy hard hat turns into hunky headwear. Alchemy is an invaluable tool for any adventurer, but it isn't just about survival. It's about going into battle with style. Give it a try. Gileon discovered a new recipe for the alchemy pot. Stylish helm, stone hard hat, bronze knife, and bronze knife. And what do you know, I found nothing of interest. That must be Gileon's skill, finding books that aren't interesting. Magazine called Pure Relaxation. Need to relax? Aroma Serenity is just what you need. It's easy to make, too. All you have to do is combine a cloak of evasion with a garment that relaxes you very much. I assume that's the garter belt. Yep. Cloak of evasion in private clothing? Okay, scratch that. I know it's the garter belt now, but I'll still put that... Wait, really? Why would they put a bookshelf in an area I can't get to it? That's just mean. Fine. Look at these other bookshelves. Alright, what about this one? A book entitled Pitfalls of Alchemy. Far too many people confuse alchemy with almighty. Do not make the same mistake. The items you create won't always be useful. In fact, some things you cook up in the alchemy pot will be worth less than the sum of their parts. For example, if you combined an iron axe with a gold nugget, you get a blunt axe. Alchemy is a wonderful way to create new things, but it's important to be aware of the pitfalls, especially when combining some expensive ingredients. Gileon discovered a new recipe for the alchemy pot, blunt axe, iron axe, and golden nugget. This is true. In fact, an example of a pitfall of alchemy is you can combine something called the metal liquid sword with some other items to make a rusty old sword. Yeah. Some alchemic creations are crap, and I would not suggest making them. Unless you're a person who really wants to get all of your recipes done, in which case do it, but I look at you funny. Anywho, guidebook entitled Traveling to Trodane. Trodane Castle is one of the most beautiful castles in the world, and rumor has it that the fourth floor is home to a powerful, one-of-a-kind magical treasure, but the royal staff aren't saying. The truth remains unknown, but one thing is for sure. There is indeed a royal treasure of different sort in Castle Trodane. That would be the lovely Princess of Trodane, Medea. She isn't just another pretty face, either. She's got a beautiful singing voice. Yes, the lovely Kingdom of Trodane is worth visiting for Princess Medea alone. Just gonna look at... Oh, nothing here. any more shelves I can look at, or... Excuse me. Ah, last one, I think. A book entitled The Forgotten Ship. Here we are! It appears to contain information about an ancient ship abandoned in the wasteland.
You owe me something. Let's read and see if you can be of any help.
You got it. The party pore over the book they found. Well, that's a convenient way to cut time. And it looks like it's nighttime already.
What we discovered is that long, long ago, the area where we found the ship was at the bottom of an ocean.
Huh, well, that is kind of helpful, I guess.
It doesn't really help us now, though. If only the ocean still existed, it would be plain sailing.
Yeah, that'd be a bad joke, Trode. Oh look, a full moon. If only we were near somewhere that we could make a moon shadow window. But wait! Even though we saw him only a few episodes ago, guess who we're going to see? Is it A? Alright, is it A? Dumagus? B? I didn't think of a B, give me a moment. Ah, King Pavan? Or C? Ishmari? I will give you some time to think this over. Pause it if you like. Okay, that's enough time. Gillian opens the moon shadow window. If you guessed C, Ishmari, you are correct. If you guessed anything else... No one would possibly have guessed anything else. And if you did, I am so sorry for you. Really, I am. Or maybe you just didn't watch enough episodes of this, or you just kind of skipped a few episodes. Either way. And Ishmari isn't... Oh, there he is. He's looking at the globe.
Ah. Welcome once more to the land of the moon shadow, fortunate travelers. The moon shadow window opens but once in a human's lifetime to grant a single wish.
Well, there is technically four of us, and the last time was for a different person.
It is mysterious indeed that we should meet for a second time.
For lucky, maybe we'll meet more times so I can get an awesome weapon. It'd be nice, but I don't think that'll happen.
Enlighten me. What wish has brought you back to the pond this night?
Gillian tells Ishmari about the ship in the wasteland, even though Ishmari could have just done the stupid shoe thing again.
I know the ship of which you speak. It would travel the vast oceans, guided by the light of the moon. I remember it well. And now you wish to return this ship to the ocean from whence it came. A simple task.
Doesn't really sound simple, but I guess for him it is, with the magic harp and all.
All you must do is revive the memory of ancient times. Those times when there was once an ocean where now there is only land.
What is with your magic and memories? Seriously, Ishmari, are you related to Naminé or something?
Yourselves in a scantha. Now I will again give form to a memory. The memory of the ocean that sleeps in the land. Yes. The music will rouse the memory.
Ishmari, I believe you said that wrong. You're supposed to go, yes. Yes. You know, like Calderasha? Or not? What?
Oh, it is as I feared. This heart is not powerful enough.
Well, crap.
I will need a greater instrument if I am to perform such a task.
Wait, but I thought you said it would have been a simple task to bring the boat back to the ocean. This is very contradictory. Okay.
Yes, it is coming to me. There is an aura that surrounds you. It is faint, but I can feel it.
Huh?
I see it. A moon shadow heart in the world of the sun's light. With that, no undertaking would be beyond the realms of possibility.
Huh.
Lend me your ear. Somewhere in your world, there is an almighty instrument. Somewhere along the path you have already trodden. A friend will guide you to it. My brave children, if you wish to awaken the ancient ship, you must first find the moon shadow heart.
Makes
bring
sense.
It to me, and I shall summon the memory of that ancient ocean. And the ship shall sail once more.
Huh. Well, I guess we have to go back to our world and think where... Who that we know, a friend, could possibly help us find the moon shadow part that he's talking about? correct me if I'm wrong, but King Pavan still owes us a favor, doesn't he? Perhaps we should go to Iscantha. But before we do that, I'm getting those vases I missed in the castle. After I have Yangus use his nose for treasure. If I'm correct, 7 treasures? Okay, if we remove the 4 that was behind that barred area, that's 3. So I missed a treasure somewhere. Should I cut this here and go after those treasures? Nah, we'll come back here at some other point, or I'll do that off screen, maybe. Let's use Zoom. And go to Iscantha. But I'm resting at the inn first, because, you know, I'm not gonna do anything with such low health and magic. Well, my health isn't that low, it's just the magic that is. And I'd rather, you know, go in on full magic. It's not I'm worried that anything will happen, it's just I feel very uneasy having my magic so low. Plus, it's nighttime, so I don't know if the king will receive us. He might be asleep anyway. Is it me or did the music for Iscantha change? Anyway. Is that a kid behind the counter? The hell? Why is there a kid behind the counter of the inn? So strange. Okay. To the king! He should be in the audience chamber, right? Yeah, now that it's daytime. Otherwise, I think he would be in his room sleeping.
What a pleasant surprise! It's so nice to see you all back at my humble home.
Humble isn't the right word for a castle, but I digress.
I'll never forget that day.
You know, now that I think about it, isn't it ironic we're coming to Pavan for this, considering we came to him the first time with Ishmari?
What brings you to my kingdom on this fine and sunny day?
After one silent explanation later.
Let's see. The Moon Shadow Heart is indeed in the Iscantha.
Makes sense. Because the legend's here.
One of our treasures is its ancient times.
Oh. So no one giving it to us?
But I cannot deny my honored friend's request. It is locked securely away in the vault below the castle. Allow me to escort you there.
Okay. That's all well and good. Is it me or... I don't like looking a gift horse in the mouth, mind you, even though that expression is weird, but this seems too easy.
Passed down from many generations of the royal family.
Looks cool.
Here we are.
Cool. The royal family of Iscantha has such cool mechanisms. Thanks, Pavan. This is a huge help, but seriously, it feels like... Oh my god! Told you it was too easy. Bastards.
I don't believe that. How can this
be? It's a lot of treasure taken, too. My My god.
It must be the work of thieves. I will not stand for this.
Settle down. Settle down, bro.
It appears that the unthinkable has happened. And the Moonshadow Harp has been stolen.
As well as everything else that was in this vault.
The culprits could still be inside this tunnel. It's too dangerous for you to go after them. You mustn't set foot inside.
Dude, do you forget that we're adventurers?
I will summon the castle guards.
I've beaten more than thieves.
They'll get the harp back. You mark my words.
Alright. Well, since he's going to do that, I'm going to go to the church and save, you know, for totally unrelated reasons. I'm going to cut this here, because you don't need to see me go back to the church. I'll be right back. Okay, and we're back. I counted all the treasure chests, by the way, here that are empty. There's 12. So that's 12 treasures we might have to recover. And one that's definitely important to us. Which way do we go? I'll go this way. I see what they did there. Well, that was interesting. Just enemies we've seen before. Muddy hands and goodie bags. Oh, that's right, I don't have a map of this. Why would I have a map of this? Who knows, maybe they dropped some stuff here. Also, I have no idea where I'm going. That was odd. There was mischievous moles there, although this is a giant hole now that I think about it, so it's not that strange. Never mind. Well, there was another path. Now that I think about it, diverging on every path in here was probably a dumb idea. Well, that was annoying. Bunch of muddy hands wouldn't leave me alone. Oh, found the hole. Huh. Where are we? Well, obviously we should be heading to that cave. Makes sense. You know what, I'm curious. Yangus, any treasure chests out here? Nothing happens. Okay. At least not over here, there isn't it. New enemies? Yep, new enemies! Mars Rovers! Kinda hitting it on the nose, but whatever. Whiplash, Angelo, you swoosh! As you can obviously tell, their recoloration of the chainines. Damn it, why didn't any of them get paralyzed? Well, as long as Swoosh takes him out, I don't care. Well, Yang's take the last one out. Oh my god, my health is low. Yay! Equipped. Flame Slash. Penny Pincher. Little Kiss. And Mid Heal. You ass. And apparently they can call for help. Because, like I said, they're asses. Give me money. Didn't give me money. Burn for your sins! Your sin of coming onto the battlefield! No. Yes. That was quick. Let's take him out quick. Ah, I knew there was a treasure chest around here. If that is a mimic of some kind, I'm gonna be annoyed. Oh good, it's just locked. Seed of Life, also nice. No. Yes. Good. This has to be the right way, right? Almost there. There it is. And there's a treasure chest over there. And we have new enemies, Mad Moles. As you could probably all imagine, they are essentially the same as Mischievous Moles, only stronger. So don't let them psych up. That would end terribly, I'm sure. Angela will put one of you bastards to sleep, hopefully. Hopefully it'll matter which one he puts to sleep, as I would like. Alright. I'd like it if I took them all out after this. Five I need to take care of. D I need to take care of. Come on. E? Okay, I'm gonna get hit by at least one psyched up, if not all of the psyched up ones. Go. Okay. So it was D, E. Hold on, let's see. Wasn't C. D, E, maybe F. So I'll attack D. Jessica will use snooze on these three, and Angela will attack C. That's just ironic. Oh, F didn't do anything, that's right. Oh, not going too bad! Aw. Yay! There we are! A lot of experience from those moles. Okay, I've started counting treasure chests from the vault we've recovered from. That would be two treasures that may have been in Ascantha. Of course, maybe they're all just in the cave. That's also possible. Okay, and here we are, in this place that I don't have a map to. But with that, I think we're going to end this episode here. So the next episode of Let's Play Dragon Quest VIII, Journey of the Cursed King, we'll be exploring this tunnel here. See you guys then!